I finally decided to upgrade the Triangular Arbitrage Finder tool that I shared last year. So I've been getting a lot of comments on the previous video asking if the tool was working or how to make it run, because you have to install some Chrome extensions to make it run. So the process was very clunky and it's not very user friendly. So I've decided to upgrade the tool and release a new version, which is a lot more easier to use and a lot more faster. Before we talk about it, if you want to understand how triangular arbitrage trading works, I suggest you to watch the excellent video that was done on this topic by Bennett. I'll leave a link for this as well in the description box. So to understand arbitrage trading, you can watch that video. Now let's talk about some key enhancements that were done in version 2. So the old one, it's not very optimized. It has to run through a 6 million loop to calculate all the opportunities. So it was very, very slow. The new one, it only has to run through 5,000 loop, and it's significantly faster than the previous one. I'll talk about this optimization in a minute after I summarize all the other aspects of the new version. Second, we used a REST API to get the Binance data and do the calculations in the previous one. So that is very slow, because REST protocol is supposed to be used only when you want to get the data for once. But in our case, we have to keep calculating it again and again, right? So we need a steady stream of information from the server every second. So in that case, it's optimal to use a socket API instead of a REST API. So I've used socket API in the tool, and it's significantly faster. And the good thing is REST APIs have a restriction on the number of calls you can make every minute. But that is not the case with socket API. You can call any number of sockets, there's no restriction. So it's faster and no restrictions. Next, the old one required a Chrome extension to be installed to use. So it's clunky and it's not very trustworthy to install Chrome extensions. This one, you don't have to install any extension. You can just run some commands and start using it right away. The old one was calculated every 5 minutes. So it's not very ideal to calculate arbitrage every 5 minutes, because trading happens so fast. You know, these opportunities, they hardly last a few seconds. So this time frame is not applicable to trading arbitrage opportunities. So this one, it runs on socket API, so it's real time. It's significantly fast. You get real updates every second. Next, the old interface was very clunky. There were a lot of options, and a lot of them are not used. So I took out all those options and simplified the interface even further. Now let's talk about how the performance was optimized and how I'm able to achieve 20x performance gain with the new version. So to understand that, you have to understand some basic components of this calculation. So whenever we take any, so this is called as a trading pair. So whenever you refer to symbols on Binance, you always refer to trading pair. A pair is composed of two assets. So BTC is an asset. USDT is an asset. We have several other assets like Ethereum, NEO, or, you know, every cryptocurrency is an asset, and they are coupled with a market to form a trading pair. So on Binance, you have 184 assets as of today. We have 184 assets and 565 tradable pairs. So these result in 5,262 arbitrageable paths. Now with version 1, in order to identify all these arbitrageable paths, I had to loop through these 184 assets three times, because it's triangular arbitrage. So it's 184 times 184 times 184. That roughly comes around 6 million. So 1 million loop takes roughly around 3.5 seconds to process. So that means 6 million records take roughly 20 seconds to calculate. So this is why version 1 took 20 seconds to perform all the calculations. Now with version 2, this 6 million loop, in order to identify all these arbitrageable paths, is only run once. And after that, these paths are stored, and every subsequent loop, every iteration that we run, is only executed on these 5,000 paths. So that's how we are able to reduce the processing time to 1 millisecond. That being said, the socket sends the data every second. So it's safe to assume 1 second as the combined processing time for version 2. So that's how we are able to reduce the runtime from 20 seconds to 1 second. And we have to bring down the calculation time less than 1 second, because remember, socket sends the data every second. So we have to be able to calculate all the calculations in less than a second. Otherwise, it causes a bottleneck. Now let's see how to install and use the tool. So you need to have Node.js installed on your system. It's a straightforward installation. I'll leave a link for this. You can just go to the site and download the current version and click next, next and install it. It's very easy. And after that, this is the link to download the tool. And you have to click on clone or download and download the zip file. Once you download and extract the zip file, you'll see these files in the folder. You have to go to this directory on command prompt and then run node index.js. That's it. And hit enter. So you get the message that Arbitrage bot has just started on port 3000. Please wait. So this is when the bot is doing the 6 million calculation. And after it does the 6 million calculation, it gives you a URL to access the tool. Okay, the setup is done. It takes roughly a minute or two to finish this whole process. And once the process is done, you can see the performance, the CPU usage comes down to around 1% and the memory is also 550 MB. So it's quite, you know, you can just leave it in the background and let it run. It's not going to eat away your performance or, you know, it's your system resources. And once the setup is finished, you get this URL to access the tool. So you can just copy this and go to your browser, open the link, and yeah, you can see that it's working. These are refreshed every second. You can see the data getting changed. You can see 1.127 and it gets refreshed every second. And if you want to trade a particular coin, you can use this toggle button. So if I click toggle, it's off now. It's not updated. And if you want to resume updating, just click on toggle. Okay. And you can let this run in the background. So this is doing all the heavy lifting. And this is just to show you the results. Okay. You can see that the interface is almost similar to the previous one because people have gotten used to it, right? So I did not want to change it because this is already what you are used to. That's it for this video. I hope you find this useful. Just leave your thoughts and suggestions in the comment section. Talk to you in the next one.